Okay, so we're here at Michael's, and what you're going to grab are two dowels. These have the green end on them. If you can see that there. Mm-hmm. You will also need to get, and this is found in the wood aisle by the jewelry box things, a package of these beads with the hole. They have a hole on both sides. This is the 5mm one. You're gonna need a package of paintbrushes. I like the tapered flat, the flat but the tapered ends. And there's a pack of them there, golden talcon, tacon. Sorry. You're gonna need two of these. These are also in the wood aisle. This is a package of assorted planks. You're gonna need two of these. Make sure you don't get the one with the pointy end. It's the square-ended ones. You'll also need two of these. This is the medium laser shape. Make sure that you check it's the right size. This was a little over 6 inches by a little over 4 inches. And there is different sizes in there. So make sure you grab the right size on these because you're gonna cut one end of it, but you need the right length. You're also gonna need assorted colors. You're gonna need, you don't have to use this brand. This was the cheapest brand there. We got bright pink, orange, bisque, red, a mustard yellow, Mediterranean blue, mint, a glossy black. This is a golden brown, so a medium brown, a gold metallic, and a darker blue. And that will be all your paint colors that you need. So at Home Depot, what you're going to need is a birch board. This is 3/4 inch by 2.5 inches, and it's found in the hardwood boards aisle. I would suggest you get birch or something kind of heavy like this, maybe oak, because it's more sturdy. The poplar is cheaper, but it's also a real soft wood, and it will dent easy and maybe split, so I would go for something like birch. Some tape is helpful. If you have some at home, that's great too. The Tight Bond Ultimate Wood Glue, I really liked it because it set up fast. It sets up in about, I'd say, 5 to 10 minutes. So you have enough time for placement, and then you can walk away, grab something to eat, and then by the time you come back, it's pretty much set. Although if you do put a lot of pressure on it, it will come off. It needs about 24 hours for that, but it will have a little bit of a working time, and then it will kind of hold, which I liked about that. And a sandpaper block, you can also use sandpaper that someone has in a garage or whatever. It doesn't have to be one of these blocks. You won't use very much of this, so if you can get some fine grit sandpaper from someone and not buy it, that's great too. And you will also need picture hangers. You can use large, medium, I think I use medium on mine, and we're using large on Kristen's, but either size will work. And these were in the aisle for
hardware.
Right, they were kind of hard to find. You might have to ask, but you'll need some of those too. So you can hang your sign if you're not going to hang it. It will kind of stand on its own too if you want to put it on a tabletop, but I like to hang hung. It looks really nice. And that's what you need from Home Depot. So what you can do at Home Depot is take your birch board or your board that you buy. There is a scan code on one of the stickers on it. You can take this over to these little portable cutting areas that they have here. And they have saws and a measuring device. This is called tape. And you can measure out. You'll need 30 inches. So you can measure out your 30 inches with their little device they have here. And then put the board in this little slot. And I'm not going to do it because I want to ruin this board. I've already done mine. And then just take it here and cut it yourself. And that will save you on some costs. If you take the piece that you want up to the cash register, they'll use a scan code on there. They'll measure how long it is, and it'll save you some money. And you can look really cool because you're sawing, and you're a woman, or possibly a man. Who knows? So what you're looking for in this is you want to make sure this is a thicker material, and you can see how tight the weave is on this. See, it's got really no stretch in this. Now versus this one, when I pull this one out, you can see how loose the weave is. You don't want a loose weave. I can almost see through this one. It will be too weak when you're trying to form the flags. You want something stiff and somewhat heavy. And you don't need very much, so it won't be that expensive. So take your two packs of three pieces of wood and separate them out into lengths. So you're going to have your two longest, two shortest, or two middle pieces, and then your two shortest. Out of these two longest, you're going to measure 3.75 inches. So one here, one here, one here, one here, and one here. And you're going to have one 5-inch piece here. On your two middle pieces, you're going to have 4 5-inch pieces. So one here, one here, one here, and one here. And then your two shortest pieces, you're going to have another 2 5-inch pieces. So one here and one here. And then with your two square blocks, you're going to take a ruler. Use the width of the ruler. It doesn't matter if it's different size than mine. You're just narrowing down this piece. Hold at the edge, draw a pencil line, and you're going to save the biggest piece. I put an X on the piece that gets thrown away. And same thing with that one. So you're going to take your blocks, you'll take your biggest one, which is for your D, and you're going to need 1, 2, 3, 4 of your longer ones, and then 5 of the short ones that you have. And you're going to roughly lay it out on your board. You want to take this block here and position it at the very edge of your board and fill it with your finger so that you know it's even, there's nothing hanging out. So that's going to show you how straight it is. You want it straight. And you're going to hold it down. You're going to take one of your extra blocks that you have and use the edge. Make sure it's one of these and not one of these because these are thinner. These have a thicker edge. You're going to lay it right there and hold it. And you're going to make a pencil mark right there and on the edge of your D. Okay? So when it comes off, you'll have this little line right here. Then you're going to go to this next one, hold it against your line, move these down a bit, take your extra board, and same thing. See how I have my fingers positioned to hold it? This one's holding this one steady, this one's holding this one up, but I've got good pressure on this one. So as I hold it steady, I make my line, then I can move those off, go into my next one, line it up. Use my board again. Oops, draw your line first once you get lined up here. Also check as you're going along that you're keeping them straight, that you have the same width across here. You can also hold them up like this. That will give you a nice straight line. draw a line here. Hold your board here, make sure that doesn't move. So we should have even spaces now throughout. They're just laying here, so don't worry about that. But you're just looking at it to make sure that everything has got the even spaces, because we're going to be coloring in those spaces before we glue these on. So our next step is to paint these and cut this edge off. So you're going to take your biggest piece of block. This is going to be for your D. You're going to need to paint two of these your mustard yellow. And if you want to, you can change the colors up. It doesn't mean that you have to do it just like me. I just followed off of what I could find on the internet. But you could make it into pinks and blues if you want to. You could use metallics if you want to. Whatever you like. And you want to have a angled flat brush. That works the best. It will give you a nice line, as you can see like here. You want it to go straight up and down. And it's also got the good flat space. Okay, get your edges really good. Then you're going to take your taupe color and dip the long end of your brush in so it looks like that. And you're going to wipe some of that off. You're going to turn it around so the long end is on the edge. And you're going to go along the edges. And what you're trying to do is bring some of that color faded in. This is going to give the antique look. You don't have to do this step if you don't want to. It's totally up to you. I wanted mine to look kind of old, because the stuff in my house is that way. It's old looking. But if you want to not do this step, you can. As I go around the corner, I sweep like this. So it will look like that. I'm not gonna paint the backside. If you wanna get fancy and paint the backside, still right at home and do that. Now I'm going to take my smallest ones and set my brush really good. So I should have five inch. I should have five of those, and we're going to use cream for that, or a bisque color. I wouldn't do stark white just because it's so stark, and that's my own personal preference. I use a little bit of a bone color. And we're gonna do the same thing. We're just gonna cover one side. And while that's still wet, I go right to my taupe color, dip in the corner. Go along the edges. Make sure to keep your brush on the right side. So you want that long side always facing
towards the edge of the wood. If I flip it around, I'm gonna start getting the white color there. I don't want that. I want this to stay on the edge.
So it like antiques it, gives it a little weathering.
Yep, so it will look like that. And if you feel like it's too heavy somewhere, like I can see the square right here, I just rinsed off my brush a little bit and I'm just going to kind of drag that in with a clean, kind of damp brush with nothing on it. Soften those edges so it doesn't look like a perfect square. It looks weathered. You can do a little bit of edge right here. Okay. And those will dry really fast because you're not putting a ton of paint on them. Make sure your paint's smooth and not globbed on. If you need to thin down your paint, thin it down with a little bit of water. Acrylic paint can be thinned with water. So just give it a little thin. If it gets goopy, start thinning it down with water. You don't want any thick lines on it or anything like that. You want it to look and appear smooth. And it will be the best workability for you if it's thin. So now we need to do, after you've done five of their short ones, now you need to do four of the 5-inch pieces for the I, Y, L, and D. So now you have 3 5-inch blocks remaining. This is for the back of the sign, or what's peeking out from behind the sign. So you're gonna need one green, one blue, and one pink. Do our pink one first. And we don't need to antique these. Okay, so now you're gonna take your piece of wood, and we've already made lines on it. You want to start at the end with the biggest square. That's where your D is gonna be. And in between these lines, you're going to paint a color. You're gonna start with a darker blue. And try to stay in your lines as much as possible, because that's how you're gonna know where to put your letters. I like a square brush like this for that. You can, in that little pack that we showed you of what to get, there's an angled brush that'll work really good too. Just go down to a smaller one so you can stay nice and steady. And when you press on your brush, it will flatten out a little bit, and then you can kind of push it to the edge of your line. It will give you more control.
Okay, so now we're going to glue our boards down. And for the first one, which is the D, we're just gonna eyeball, because that's how I do things. You want the same amount on each side, and you want it to be flush to the end of the board, or somewhat flush at least. And you're gonna go off of this line that you made. If it's sticking over here, you know that's not right. So based off that line. With this glue, I got this tight bond. I like it because it dries in about 8 to 10 minutes, but it's not a full dry, it's just like a tack dry. So it will kind of be sturdy, but if you put a lot of pressure on it, it will come off. But it does give you a little bit of working time too. So I'm gonna take my glue. And then before I place it, I do want to kind of get somewhat centered, because I don't want to have to get glue all over the back side of it too much. Okay. And this will be the eye. And you want to offset this one so it has a little bit hanging off the edge. Most of it's going to be off the top. I'm just laying this out to get it figured out for myself here, because your next one's going to go straight too. Okay. So as you can see, there's about, I don't know, 3/4 of an inch down here at the bottom, and then that much on top. Put your glue down. See how much it can wiggle? That's what you want. And I'm looking at making sure that width is the same all the way down. Now I'm taking a smaller one. This will be the S. Down to the same edge as this one. I'm going to raise this one up just a little bit. If for some reason you got off on your colors, don't worry about it. You can take a really thin brush and go in there and recolor it. It's not a big deal. It probably won't show unless you really, really got off, which you shouldn't have because you had it marked, but it's not a big deal. Don't panic if you can see a little bit of wood underneath there. And like I said, you're gonna have about 7-8 minutes where it's gonna still move on you. So even if it does get a little crooked, you can come back and fix it. Okay, D-I-S-N-E. This is our Y, so a long board for this one, and the Y is going to match up to the top, but it's going to hang down on the bottom. Okay, I'm going to move this over a little bit for Kristen. Now we're back to an L, another long one. Whoa, I got a little crazy on the glue there, guys. And we're going to go back to the same as we have down on the other side. I could have used a little better piece of wood for that. Sorry, Kristen, yours is really antiqued. A little bird smacked your sign. I'm going to bring this down just a touch. There we go. A. So you need a short piece. In and D will be a long piece again. Okay, now I'm just going to step back and let it look at it, make sure it's pretty much straight. Again, I'm not the type of person that gets stressed out if something's a little bit crooked, but if you are, you'll be messing with this thing forever. See this one, I can feel that it's starting to set. Okay, that looks a little bit. I got a little glue, if you wanna see that. See that little bit of glue right there? If you got a 10, I would try to wipe it off with something. I'm just gonna let that dry. I'm not gonna be too stressed about it. If it shows after it's dry, I'll just put a little pink over it. So try not to put so much that it squeezes out. You just want like a nice little flat area. That was the only one that did it, so. But that man I had, it was pretty good. Now we let that dry. I'm going to raise this D up a little bit. I'm going to raise this D like this. So come back over here. It was down further. I want it to be even with this eye. So I raise that D up just slightly like that. So the eye is kind of in the middle of it. There. Okay, now we let it dry. Okay, so now I've just arranged the letters on the blocks just to see what it would look like. And I'm gonna take a piece of masking tape or painter's tape and I'm going to mark off the line where I want the letters to set. I'm gonna move this Y because it's gonna get in the way. And now we're going to trace the letters onto here. So I'm basically just going to center them and lay them on top of this masking tape, and we're going to take a pencil and trace around them.
Once you get your letters traced, I'm using a small angle brush and I'm just following my lines. And this is when it's really good to have thin paint. So thin it down with water if you need to. And I'll go around the outside of the letters first. And I always keep the long end of the brush towards the outside because that will give you a nice sharp edge. So now we're going to mark the holes for the flags, and you're just going to take a pencil and draw a little circle like I have right here. The first one goes in between the D and the I, right there. The next one goes right in the middle of the S, so right there. Make sure that when you mark these, you're putting it in the middle of the board because there's going to be a drill going down. You don't want that drill to go out this way. It has to be straight down. So you got to leave yourself room on each side. Middle of the N, at the very front part of the E, right there. Last part of the Y, right there. And then right in the middle of the A, and right at the end of the N. And I did look on the sign for this as to where they were placed. So you want to go and have someone, or you can do it yourself. I held the sign when my husband drilled it down.
Okay, so you're going to take your dowels. And I got mine at Michael's. They're the green-ended ones. That's the ones I used. And you're going to measure off 10 and mark it, 9 and mark it, 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4. So you'll have all 7 of them. There's going to be 7 of them. And then once you make your mark, you can just take a pair of scissors. And cut them off. It's okay if it's a little bit jagged, it doesn't matter. It's going to be stuck into that hole that we just made. And you're going to fill the end about halfway. So I just let the glue come out and I just let it kind of drop. Oops. Into there, and then stick your dowel in. Oh shit! Kind of. Oh, there's two sides to this. I don't know. And you kind of have to go kind of tight on this. It takes a little bit of pressure. If you twist and do it, it will get it in there better. So you're gonna have a little stand like that, and you're gonna do that to every. One. Now you're going to have these cute little sticks and they will dry, but we're going to move on to painting them. So this is when you're going to get your gold paint out and we're going to paint these gold. So now you're going to cut out your template that we've given you for the flag. You're going to place it on your piece of canvas and you're going to cut out 7 of these. And you want to try to get this as exact as possible. Use a pencil, don't use a Sharpie because you don't want the color to bleed through your material. Or else you're going to have a mess on your hands because it will bleed through the paint most likely too. Okay, so now we're going to start the flags.
The fray check has dried and you can see where it's kind of stiff at the edges. I chose 7 colors and some of them are already on the sign and some of them aren't. So I've done pink, red, a medium blue. That's the same blue that's on the lighter blue that's on the sign. The green, I added orange, mustard yellow was already on there, and then I added a light blue. And then I have my flag posts off to the side here, and we're going to go in a specific order. So the first flag is going to be pink, and you're going to use your 9-inch pole. So you're going to take your paint, and you're going to paint onto this fabric. And this will be messy, so be prepared with the paper towel down and for your fingers to get gross. Because not only are we going to use this paint, but we're also going to use glue. And you're going to paint both sides. The reason I paint both sides is because when I fold it over, if the sides don't line up perfectly, it will still be painted. And you won't be able to tell that they're not lined up perfectly. And also it will make it stiffer and more moldable for when we do the glue. Okay, so now I'm gonna take some glue and I'm gonna put a spot right here like so. And then I'm gonna take my finger and I'm gonna rub that around. It all to the edges. The paint will also help it adhere. That's another reason why we're doing this wet and not letting them dry. But you want to make sure the glue's all the way around. And now you're going to semi-fold it over, take it to the top of the pole here, and you're going to press them together. And I don't know if you can see this, but see right here, there's a little bit of this still showing. That's okay. See, we painted the inside, so you won't even ever be able to see that. And then you're going to take the end of your nail and just push that together so it kind of creates the seam. Now, to make the flag wave, you're going to bunch it together like this. Squeeze those ends together. I might need a little bit more glue on there. So it's going to look like that. If it starts coming, like I need a little bit more glue right there. It's not quite wet enough. Spread that around. There we go. You really want it saturated. Okay, and then I'm going to just put this off to the side and make sure that it's still really tight to the flagpole. And I'm going to put it over to the side in my little area where I had them sticking out, and I'm going to let it just sit there while it dries.
Okay, so now we're going to put the back blocks on this. Okay, so now we're going to put the back of the opposite side of the sign on this. This is a little bit tricky, and this is where your eyeballing is going to come in. So what I did was I just lifted this up and slid these underneath and kind of got them where I want them in a way, of sorts, I guess you'd say. They're not glued or anything like that. So this would be your D, the back of your D. This would be the back of your I. This would be the back of your Y. And this is the back of your L if it was on the opposite side. So what we want to do is this block would hang down as far as these. So I just eyeball it, looking straight down until I see it kind of get even with those there and the top of that one. And this one would be even at the top with these and even with the Y. And then this one would be at the bottom of these. And then this one would be in the middle of everything and on the edge. And then you want to pay attention to spacing too. Like there should be that much space between it, just like there would be here. And the same there. Okay. So now that I have that lined up, I'm going to lift this up very carefully because I want them to stay in just about the same spot. Set that aside. Then I'm going to put glue. Right in the middle of these, a straight line across. I'm going to bring my sign back over here. And I'm going to just rest my fingertips down until I get it about where I want it. So it's not touching those blocks yet. I have my fingertips holding it up. And I want to move this around until I get... Remember, you have workability with this glue. It's not like it's going to just set down and go, but I kind of want to get it close where I need to be. Okay, so right there. It till it gets up to the end, let it fall inside that space there. Kind of a slow process, but you don't want to have to be all messy. And concealer. There is the sign.